Hi, this is José Luis, and in this video, I would like to teach you what enumeration types are in C#, or enums for short, okay? And the basic idea is actually quite simple. And I have written some code here that I would like to use to illustrate when are enums actually pretty useful. So imagine that we are writing some kind of, imagine we work for a large retail online store of some kind. You probably know what I'm thinking about right now. And we're writing some kind of software that is trying to track the status of a particular package going to your place, okay? And there are discrete different statuses that the package can have. It might be still in the warehouse. It might be on its way, flying to your house. It might be out for delivery, or it might already be shipped, okay? So all of those are possible different states. Now, how do we represent those states in memory in our program with variables? Well, very typically, instead of keeping a string as a variable that says shipped for delivery or blah, 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 keeping strings is fairly expensive memory-wise, but also comparing them and saying if the string is shipped or if the string is out for delivery, that is also a pretty expensive comparison, computationally speaking. So a very common way of doing this used to be using integers, because since we know that there are a set of different discrete options, like for example, 5 different options of how a package might be status-wise, then we can represent those with numbers that go from 0 to 4. And if the status equals 0, we know it's out for delivery. If the status is 1, we know it's already shipped, whatever that is, right? And then we can make decisions based on that. So for example, I have a very simple program here that when I run, figure out first, it prints to the console the number that we have used to represent the package status, all right? And then I have a set of if else that checks the value of this variable, package status, and if it's 0, it prints a message that it hasn't left facilities, or the package is on its way, or the package is delivered for 0, 1, or 2. Okay, so this is great, it's fine, this works. Now, the problem with this is that for large programs or for teams of people who might not be familiar with the convention that we're using for representing numbers and status, this can be confusing and this can lead to a lot of errors. Because if, for example, I forget what 0, 1, or 2 means, then I might write code that is not working correctly according to that convention. But also, if I want to extend things, say for example that I have 3 status, it hasn't left the facilities, the package is traveling, but I forgot to add another situation where the package is out for delivery. So because I'm already using the number 2 for when the package is delivered, I kind of cannot insert it between 1 and 3, but then creating an else if that is if package status is 3 is out for delivery, it's kind of counterintuitive because it feels that it should be before 2, which is like the end of the package being delivered. So it can be a little confusing and it could lead to errors. So that's why in C# and in many other programming languages, we have this structure called enumeration types. And enumeration types is basically a way of saying, a way of creating a set of constants that have a particular name and that represent internally underlying, they represent just integer numbers, but the way we use them, we read them and we compare them is by their constant name, which for us humans makes things much easier because instead of the value of 0 being still not shipped, I can just write this still has not shipped. As a constant name, right? And then that comparison is much easier to read, much easier to write, and then we don't really care about which number is underlying that. Let me show you an example of that. So for example, I'm going to write here inside of the class, a new enumeration type, which is going to be called, for example, status, all right? And you can see that I'm using the enum keyword and that I am writing here the word that I choose for the category, the general type of things. And then inside, I'm going to write all the possible statuses that I can, that my package can have. So for example, so I'm going to say the first one is going to be in store. The first second one is going to be in transit. And the last one is going to be delivered, for example. So my stat, my a package can only have three status: still in the warehouse, it's on its way to you, and it has been delivered. So it's over. So each one of these actually have a number. You see, so for example, in store, if you see me hovering, you see that number zero pops up. In transit, number one pops up. Deliver, number two pops up. But I don't care, because I'm only going to refer to this from now on, not by their number, but by their name. So for example, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to rewrite my program so that it's easier for me to understand and to track what's going on. So first of all, this variable, I'm going to replace it. And now instead of being an integer, it's going to be of the type status, because a status is now a type of things. And then the name is going to be package status. And then I'm going to initialize this to a particular value. You can see that it's already giving me a suggestion, status dot, and you can see that I have three possible options: in store, in transit, delivered. So for example, let's say that it is still in store. So it's at the very beginning. So that way you can see that now my package status is a variable of the type status, which I just created here. And the initial value is that it is in the store. And now I can rewrite my conditional statement and say, well, package status, if this equals to status.inStore, then it still hasn't left facilities. Otherwise, if it equals status in transit, then it means it's on its way. And if it is status.delivered, it means that the package has been delivered here. So now I can run this code, and then it looks like, oh, what did I do here? Okay, sorry. Yes, I moved things around. All right. So you see now the package status printout is not even printing the number anymore. It's printing that it's from the type in store, and package hasn't left facilities. Otherwise, here, for example, if I print delivered, then I can run this and then the package has been delivered. All right. Okay, cool. And so this not only is easier to read and to write and understand from a human perspective, but it's also much more maintainable. Because if I want to add a new status to my program, the only thing that I need to do is just go here and add, for example, out for delivery. This is a very common one. And I may just want to actually change, just put it here in the middle. And you can see how immediately the number two is not delivered anymore, is out for delivery. You can see this from the tooltip, and deliver has changed to number three. But that doesn't matter, because my code doesn't depend on numbers anymore. So I don't need to remember to change them. I only need to remember that that their names. So for example, now here in the middle, I can say else if package status equals status out for delivery. So you will receive your package very soon. Okay. And then I can just, for example, here, this is out for delivery. And I'm going to run this code. And yes, I'm going to receive my package very soon. All right. Okay, so this is enumerators. It's just basically, as a summary, it's basically a way of giving names to numbers so that we can use them as a type. And as a type that has a set of discrete different different constants inside of it. So for example, here the type is the status, and the possible values that a status can have is in store, in transit, out for delivery, whatever, which is just names that are basically hiding numbers behind of them. Okay? All right, enums are really useful when we're writing programs and we want to differentiate things by types or by statuses or by different properties that they may have. They're actually pretty useful, and they make writing code much more resilient and much easier for humans. So I really recommend that you give them a try and you check them out and you implement them in your own programs. Okay? Thank you very much and see you in the next video.